Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 70th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 9-3. The booster which launched this mission, B1063, then landed successfully for the 19th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. Unfortunately, there was an issue during the flight that caused the mission to ultimately be unsuccessful. SpaceX posted during tonight's Falcon 9 launch of Starlink, the second stage engine did not complete its second burn. As a result, the Starlink satellites were deployed into a lower than intended orbit. SpaceX has made contact with five of the satellites so far and is attempting to have them raise orbit using their ion thrusters. Musk posted some information on what caused the issue with the second stage. He said upper stage restart to raise perigee resulted in an engine rudd for reasons currently unknown. Team is reviewing data tonight to understand root cause. Starlink satellites were deployed, but the perigee may be too low for them to raise orbit. Michael Sheets posted about some information from the FAA on this Falcon 9 mission issue. He said the FAA is requiring an investigation of the Starlink 9-3 mission in-flight failure, the agency says in a statement. Heading to Boca Chica, the tower section Module 4 was moved from the port to Starbase. The fifth module for the launch tower was also seen moved from port to Starbase. The first Launch Tower 2 module was seen lifted and stacked with the base of the tower. Also, the second Launch Tower 2 module was moved to the launch site and hooked up to a crane. The Ring Watch has posted some pictures and information about a new test article spotted at Starbase. They said last night team stacked a new structural test article in Megabay 2 which will likely undergo compression testing at some point. This tank appears to be similar to the old S26.1 test tank qualifying the structure of the new aft section and tank. They also posted some pictures and information about a new payload section that's been spotted. They said, now that is a very outfitted payload bay for a Block 2 ship. Quite possibly flight hardware, although that remains to be seen. Lots of new stuff. Starship 31 was seen being moved over and into Megabay 2. Booster 12 was seen performing a spin prime test on the orbital launch mount. To finish up the video, we'll take a look at the Cameron County website where SpaceX have some closures. They currently have a closure scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 15th, with backup possible closures on Tuesday 16th and Wednesday 17th. In addition to the full road closures, SpaceX have some temporary road closures as well. The temp closures are for today, Sunday 14th through to Friday 19th. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.